sights of the beautiful MGM Grand Garden Arena, where tomorrow night, the world title bout between Terrence Crawford and Victor Postol is going down. But before that, all the fighters must step on the scale and make weight today. It's been a great fight week, and it's going to be culminating tomorrow night right behind us where they're building the ring. But first, I am joined here inside the MGM Grand Garden Arena for our live weigh-in show. Make some noise, everybody. All right. I'm joined by my co-host here, Kieran Mulvaney. Kieran, I know all the buzz is about the main event. We do have a stacked undercard, but this is what boxing's about. Two guys risking their undefeated record, putting it all on the line for supremacy at 140.
Absolutely. We've got 28-0 against 28-0, the number one guy in the division against the number two guy in the division. It's what we want from boxing. And you know the other thing I like about this? These are two guys who don't talk smack. They're going to do all their talking in the ring.
Got a great undercard for you, too. The likes of Oscar Valdez going for his first title, WBO. We have Alexander Vozdik, who's been added in our opening fight because Gilberto Zerto Ramirez hurt his hand. And then in what I think could be the fight of the night, Francisco Chia Santana against Jose Benavidez Jr. Stacked undercard, right?
Absolutely. But before we go to the pay-per-view, we are going to have some other undercard fights that you're going to be able to watch on TopRank.com. And those guys are getting ready to weigh in. And to take us through the weigh-in, the one and only Lupe Contreras.
Thank you very much, guys. Ladies and gentlemen, it's my great honor to welcome you all to the biggest stage in professional boxing, the MGM Grand Garden Arena. It is unification, the best fighting the best. You have your champion for the WBC at 140 pounds. You have your champion from the WBO at 140, both undefeated, putting their crowns and their O's on the line. It is our main event, Crawford versus Postol, but as my co-host mentioned here this afternoon, we will begin with our prelims tomorrow night. First on the scale, four rounds in the light heavyweight division. We welcome to the stage from Omaha, Nebraska, 2-0, both of his victories coming by way of KO, Steve Nelson facing off against the fighter from Canutillo, Texas, 5-2 with one draw. Three of those victories coming by way of knockout, Tim Meek. Nelson Meek, four rounds in the light heavyweight division. Once again, being presented to you by Hall of Fame boxing promoter Bob Arum's Top Rank Incorporated, along with La Cerveza Tecate Born Bold, Hands of Stone, the true story of Roberto Duran, starring Edgar Ramirez, Robert De Niro, Usher Raymond, in theaters August 26th, being broadcast worldwide on HBO pay-per-view as well as TopRank.com, and of course, our gracious host, the MGM Grand of Las Vegas. First on the scale, ladies and gentlemen, undefeated at 2-0, both by way of KO from Omaha. This is Steve Nelson on the scale. £173, the official weight for Steve Nelson. Entering the ring for the third time as a pro at 2-0, two KOs. Across the ring, ladies and gentlemen, from Canutillo, Texas, Tim Meek weighing in. Meek on the scale. £171, the official weight for Tim Meek. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, opening up our card tomorrow night. Four rounds, light heavyweight division. For the third time as a pro at 2-0, two KOs, Steven Nelson facing off against the fighter. Entered the ring for the ninth time as a pro, 5-2-1 with three KOs, Tim Meek out of Texas. Ladies and gentlemen, if you don't have your tickets in hand quite yet, some of the top prospects in the sport, many of them making their Las Vegas debut, fighting up against the toughest opposition they've yet to face. Get there early tomorrow. The future stars of boxing will be featured tomorrow night here on the biggest stage in the sport, the MGM Grand Garden Arena. Our next bout to the scale, six rounds in the middleweight division. fighting out of Slavutich, Ukraine, 10 victories, 1 defeat, 8 coming by way of KO. We have Stanislav Skorokun facing off against a fighter from Asbury Park, New Jersey, undefeated at 6-0. Four of those victories coming by way of KO.
One way in down, a few more to go here as we weigh in the undercard leading up to our pay-per-view card. Buy the pay-per-view. Check with your local cable providers. It's going to be a great night of boxing. Look, in our main event, Terrence Crawford versus Victor Postol. You got two guys, 28-0, undefeated. The one versus the two at the 140-pound division, putting it all on the line, risking it all in a fight. These guys have trained so hard. They don't do any trash talking. And if you're a fan of boxing, you love boxing, these are the kind of fights that you should support and you should want to buy. On our undercard co-main event, you have Oscar Valdez going against a tough Matias Rueda. Both undefeated. Both have crazy high knockout percentages and a chance to maybe see a new world champion for Top Rank with Oscar Valdez at the featherweight title for the WBO. But first, we have a few more fights to weigh in, so let me send it over now to Lupe Contreras.
Ladies and gentlemen, our next bout to the scale, 6 rounds in the middleweight division, 10-1 with 8 KOs, fighting out of Slavutich, Ukraine. Stanislav Sokorod on the scale. £155, 155, the official weight for Sokorod. Across the ring in the red corner, putting his undefeated 6-0, 4 KO record on the line. Welcome to the scale, Hakeem Bryant. £155, 155, the official weight for Hakeem Bryant, fighting out of Asbury Park, New Jersey. 6-0, 4 KOs, facing off against the fighter from the Ukraine, 10-1, 8 KOs, Stanislav Skorokod. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, if you don't have your tickets in hand, make sure you join us. Get there early tomorrow. Some of the top young fighters in the sport, many of them putting their undefeated records on the line against their toughest opposition to date. Get there early. It will be fireworks here at the MGM Grand Garden Arena.
As mentioned, we have three great supporting bouts on the pay-per-view. Opening up, we have light heavyweight action. Alexander Vozdik from Ukraine. He is 10-0 with 8 knockouts. He has one heck of a right hand, and he's going up against Tommy Carpensi. Carpensi recently fought for a light heavyweight title. Didn't go the way he wanted it to, but he's going to try and make a statement and upset young Alexander Vozdik. We have welterweight action as well. Jose Benavidez Jr. He's undefeated as well. He recently scored a victory over the tough Mauricio Herrera. He's moving up from 140 to 147 pounds. And he's taking on Francisco Santana, who at just 30 years old is already a veteran of 11 years. And finally, in the co-main, we have Oscar Valdez Jr. He's in action against Matias Rueda from Argentina. So that's going to be a tough fight for Valdez. And now we go back to Lupe Contreras.
Ladies and gentlemen, we continue the official way in our next bout to the scales. 10 rounds in the super lightweight division, fighting out of Leppington, Australia. 34 victories, 2 defeats. 24 of those victories coming by way of KO. Lenny Zapavigna facing off against a very rugged fighter of Dalian, China. 18-1, 1 no contest, 13 KOs. Lian Hui Ik Yang. Yang Zapavigna, 10 rounds, super lightweight division. First on the scale, ladies and gentlemen, he enters the ring for the 37th time as a pro from Leppington, Australia. Round of applause for Lenny Zapavigna weighing in. £143, the official weight for Lenny Zapavigna. Across the ring in the red corner, Lianhui Ik Yang on the scale. £143, the official weight for Ik Yang, Yang Zapavigna. 10 rounds in the super lightweight division. Ladies and gentlemen, card tomorrow evening ripe with international flavor. Australia, China on the stage facing off. 10-round super lightweight division, part of our prelims tomorrow night here at the MGM Grand Garden Arena.
As always, we ask you guys to join the conversation with us on social media. Send us your tweets at Top Rank using the hashtag CrawfordPostol for the main event. Use at TR Boxing on Twitter and on Instagram. Also at TR Boxeo. Send us your thoughts on who you think will win the undercard fights. Will it be a boxing match? Will it go the distance? Will it be a controversial decision? Do you think Terrence Crawford or Postol will get a knockout? Send us your thoughts. We go on the air tomorrow at 3 p.m. Pacific. We will get some of those tweets read on the air during our pre-show before the pay-per-view starts at 6. So be sure to join the conversation with us and become part of Fight Night.
Introducing TopRank.com, an all-new way to provide fans with the ultimate in boxing entertainment. Watch live events. Get breaking news. And chat with fighters, fans, and boxing personalities. Download our free iOS app, Top Rank TV. Or enjoy TopRank.com on your mobile device or tablet. TopRank.com is available any place, on any device. Exclusive, interactive, accessible. TopRank.com. This is boxing.
Ladies and gentlemen, our next bout to the scale, 10 rounds in the middleweight division. Out of Tokyo, Japan, he is the 2012 Olympic gold medalist, now undefeated pro. 10 victories, 7 KOs, Ryota Murata on the scale. £161, for the undefeated Ryota Murata. Next from Lawton, Oklahoma, representing the Comanche Nation, Comanche boy Joe Tedder-Napper on the scale. £161.5, the official weight for the Comanche boy George Tedder-Napper. Tedder-Napper, Murata, 10 rounds, middleweight division. Part of the prelims tomorrow evening at the MGM Grand Garden Arena. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, it is the best fighting the best. Crawford-Postol unification, one of the best fights that can possibly be made right now. The undefeated world champion for the WBO, the undefeated world champion from the WBC. They meet in the ring tomorrow night. If you don't have your tickets quite yet, make sure you get them. Once again, proudly presented to you by Hall of Fame boxing promoter Bob Arum's Top Rank Incorporated, along with La Cerveza Tecate, Born Bold, Hands of Stone, The true story of Roberto Duran, coming to theaters August 26th, starring Edgar Ramirez, Robert De Niro, along with pop star Usher Raymond as Sugar Ray Leonard. Make sure you catch the motion picture debuting Friday, August 26th, as well as being broadcast on HBO pay-per-view, TopRank.com, and our host, the MGM Grand Garden Arena.
Okay, as we mentioned earlier, we have some good undercard fights on the pay-per-view, and there's a couple of guys who are really going to be worth looking out for. First of all, let's talk a little bit more about that light heavyweight bout that's going to introduce our pay-per-view card. We've got a guy called Alexander Vozdik. You probably haven't seen him on TV before, but if you were around for the Pacquiao-Bradley fight in April, you would have seen, and you were in the arena, you would have seen him take on Najib Mohammadi, a former world title challenger, and he pretty much annihilated him. This is a guy with a great right hand, tremendous knockout power. He's got a good amateur background as well. He won a bronze medal at the 2012 Olympics. A lot of pedigree in Alexander Vozdik. Talking of Olympians who have great pedigree, Oscar Valdez Jr. is going to be fighting in the co-main event. He's a tremendous, tremendous featherweight talent. He may be one of the very best prospects in boxing right now. He's going to be taking on undefeated Matias Rueda. Rueda, only his second time fighting outside of Argentina. He's going to have a tough task ahead of him because Valdez really is one heck of a fighter. We are probably about 30 minutes away from weighing in the main event for Saturday night. Terence Crawford against Victor Postol. And look, I don't want to spoil the suspense, but I can tell you, these guys are going to make weight. These are tremendous professionals. They're in terrific shape. They've been working very hard with their trainers. Postol working with Hall of Fame trainer Freddie Roach out of the Wild Card Gym in Los Angeles. This is the fourth fight that he's done with Freddie Roach. And Freddie said to me yesterday he really liked working with Victor Postol because he's a hard worker, he's a good guy, he shows up on time, he puts in the rounds. One thing he said, you know, don't spring any surprises on him. He likes to work off a schedule. Don't tell him he's going to box six rounds in sparring tomorrow if you're going to have him do eight. But he works real hard, but he's fairly new to working with Freddie Roach. In contrast, Terence Crawford, of course, has been working with his team for a long, long time. A team that he's very comfortable with from Omaha, Nebraska. They worked some of their time in Nebraska, but when they go into camp for the big fights, they often go to Colorado Springs, Colorado, to get away from that hometown pressure. But if you notice that Terence Crawford always looks incredibly calm and incredibly relaxed, Brian McIntyre, his chief trainer, said to me yesterday, you know what, that's because we've been preparing for this for a very long time. We've been getting ready for days like this since Terence Crawford was 12. All right, we'll go back to weigh in some more fights with Lupe Contreras.
Ladies and gentlemen, our next bout to the scale, six rounds in the welterweight division. You probably notice an ocean of purple and gold. This next gentleman on the scale, fighting out of Detroit, Michigan, 11 victories, one lone defeat, one draw, three KOs, representing the Omegas. Edward Williams on the scale. .144.5, the official weight for Edward Williams. Across the ring in the red corner, fighting out of Houston, Texas, Chris Don Edwards on the scale. .144.5, 144.5, the official weight for Chris Don Edwards. Six victories, one lone defeat, three of those victories coming by way of KO, fighting out of H-Town, Houston, Texas. Williams Edwards, six rounds in the welterweight division.
As my partner Kieran mentioned, this fight in our main event between Victor Postol and Terrence Crawford is for supremacy at the 140-pound division. Both of these guys being undefeated. One in Victor Postol brings Freddie Roach into his corner. Since he started the last three fights with Freddie Roach, we've seen him improve each and every time. That knockout against Lucas Matisse, which got him the WBC title, which he will carry with him into the ring tomorrow night, was a spectacular performance, and it upset many people didn't see coming. The route for Terrence Crawford to win the title, he'll be defending it for his third time against... He went against Hank Lundy, he went against Ray Belchon, he's been against a lot of competition, but you know what? This will be his toughest test to date. He won't agree to that. He won't say, I don't know until I get in there if it will be. But many people know what Victor Postol brings into the ring and do agree that this will be the toughest test. And the guy that wins this fight, sky is the limit for them. Not only are they the lineal champ at the division, a two-time WBC and WBO champion, but there's a lot of other talent if Terrence Crawford decides to move up to 147. If Postol, he's big for 140. He's got great height and a great reach and a great jab at that division. There's so much on the line for these guys. They both know it, and they've trained so very hard for this fight come tomorrow. You won't want to miss it.
Larry, the 19,000 that this place seats, and I don't see many empty seats. And Bowles on the assault, putting pressure still on the champion.
Oh, he hurt him with the right hand.
Yeah, he's done. Well, here's Gamboa, and across the landing some shots.
Oh, he dropped him, hit him with the right hand and the left hand, and the knee went down.
As soon as Gamboa got offensive, Crawford dropped him.
There's no quitting Gamboa. He keeps battling, falling forth. Oh my God, drops him again. It's all over.
Terrence Crawford has become an American star.
I've always liked Delorme's style, and he's got a very good, strong, hard punch. And he is going to be at his natural weight, of course, and we're all waiting to see how Crawford will take this jump up, and will they carry his power into the higher division.
Oh, nice. That puts it back on his heels. Is Delorme hurt?
He goes down! He goes down with one knee! He hit him with a shot, put him back up against the ropes, and he was hurt!
And it was a beauty!
Well, that answers another solid right hand. A lot of time to go in this round. Uppercuts, can he stop him right now? That's the second time down.
His legs are really rubbery.
And Crawford pouring it on. Blast a little shot. He better answer, the ref's going to stop the fight. He's giving him the excuse. And down he goes for the third time. That's it. The fight's all over.
Terrence Bud Crawford is just getting better and better and better.
Looking for?
As a reminder, join the conversation with us on social media all fight night long tomorrow night. We go on the air at 3 p.m. Pacific with our live stream on Top Rank TV before the pay-per-view starts at 6 p.m. Use the hashtag CrawfordPostol and send us your tweets to at TRBoxing, at TRBoxeo, even send them to me, at Crystina Poncher, and we'll get some of those read during our pre-show online. But again, check with your local cable provider to buy the pay-per-view. In our opening bout tomorrow night at 6 p.m. Pacific, you have Oleksandr Vozdek going against Tommy Karpensi in what is going to be a great opening fight on the card. A lot of action last time Vozdek was here. A spectacular knockout performance, and that earned him his spot back again. Then we have Oscar Valdez fighting for a world title for his first time against a tough Mateus Ruiz, and then Jose Benavidez Jr. going against Francisco Chia Santana in what I think will be an action-packed fight. So make sure you buy that pay-per-view and support these guys who will give it all in the ring tomorrow night here from the MGM Grand Garden Arena.
All right, well, that is our non-pay-per-view undercard fights all weighed in. Coming up now, what we have are the four fights that are going to be on the pay-per-view. The main event, of course, Terence Crawford against Victor Postol. As we have said before, two undefeated guys, two 28-0 guys, the top two guys in their division battling for supremacy right here at the MGM Grand Garden Arena in Las Vegas. As a reminder, the undercards fights will stream on TopRank.com at 3 p.m. 6 p.m. Pacific will be the start of the HBO pay-per-view featuring all those four fights. The main events coming up and the three other pay-per-view fights. Stay with us.
Welcome to the beautiful MGM Grand Garden Arena, where tomorrow night we will see who reigns supreme at the junior welterweight division, the 140-pound division. You have two undefeated champions, the WBO champion Terence Crawford taking on the WBC champion in Victor Postol. These two are risking it all. Somebody's O has got to go, as they say in boxing, and you're going to be in for a great pay-per-view telecast. Make sure to check with your local cable provider. We have Ukrainian talent Oleksandr Vozdek opening up the card, a knockout artist. He'll be the first fight tomorrow night. Then we get into Chia Santana against Jose Benavidez Jr. Great, great fight. And then Oscar Valdez fighting for his first world title against Mateus Ruida. But first, we got to have these guys get on the scale and make weight. But we have a special guest joined with my co-host. Let's send it over to Kieran Mulvaney.
I am joined here by a very, very special guest indeed, the legendary Hall of Famer, Roberto Duran, and helping us out with translation, because he doesn't have enough to do today, Lupe Contreras. Champion, look, you've been in so many great Las Vegas fights. What are Terence Crawford and Victor Postol feeling right now on the verge of their first big fight?
Usted, campeón, ha tenido tantas grandes peleas aquí en Las Vegas. ¿Qué sienten en este momento los dos peleadores en el combate estelar?
Bueno, en un compromiso como este, los dos tan nerviosos, los dos están tratando de ganar por lo más rápido posible, y Eso es, ahora mismo todo eso es nervio y lo importante es ganar la pelea. Ahora mismo ellos están en un lado que para mí es la maravilla del mundo, que es aquí el MGM. Así que cualquier lado que pueden ganar, están ganados. O sea, ganan. Así que los dos ahora mismo están nerviosos. ¿Quién va a ganar esta noche?
He said they're both very nervous at this particular moment. The whole point is to win the fight. He says, obviously, just like he was when he first arrived in Vegas, you're fascinated by all the wonders there that this city has to offer. But most of all, they're probably having a lot of nerves. But the goal is to win, surpass that, and try to give your best fight tomorrow night.
I've got to ask you also, the movie Hands of Stone, about your life, coming out later this next month. Have you seen the movie? What is it like to see your life being portrayed on the silver screen?
Le tengo que preguntar sobre la película de Hands of Stone. ¿Ha visto la película y qué siente usted ver su vida en la pantalla grande?
Bueno, vi la película en Cannes, en París. Es una película muy buena, muy llamativa, y le digo a todo el público que la vea, que le va a gustar, porque no solamente estamos pensando en esta, sino en otra película más, porque como tengo mucho de la memoria, pues entonces el público es el que va a decidir si la película está buena o no está buena.
He says he's had a chance to see the movie at the Cannes Film Festival. It was a very emotional experience for him. He says he's hoping there'll be another part because he has so many stories to tell that there has to be a sequel. There's so many ideas in his head that there has to be another chapter to this movie.
I'll tell you what, why don't we all now take the opportunity to have a little look at Hands of Stone.
Thank you. We are in for a serious fight.
The new golden era for boxing begins with Roberto Duran. Sugar
Ray Leonard. I don't lose.
He needs to come back.
You know how it is to be hungry?
Duran should fight no one but me.
I will beat him. Is that a real fighter or a clown?
Hands of Stone, in theaters everywhere, August 26th.
Ladies and gentlemen, we continue with the official weigh-in. Our next bout to the scales, featured on our pay-per-view telecast, 10 rounds in the welterweight division. Fighting out of Phoenix, Arizona, he is a 15-time national amateur champion. Also the former WBA interim world champion, 24-0, 16 KOs, Jose Benavides Jr. facing off against an absolute favorite of all hardcore boxing fans. He has taken away the O from many a fighter before and looking to do the same tomorrow evening here at the MGM Grand Arena. From Santa Barbara, California, 24 victories, only 4 defeats, 1 draw, 12 KOs, Francisco Chia Santana, Santana Benavides Jr., 10 rounds in the welterweight division. First on the scale, ladies and gentlemen, once again putting his undefeated record on the line, the former WBA interim world champion, 24-0, 16 KOs to his record, Jose Benavides Jr. on the scale. ...146.5 pounds, 146.5, the official weight for the undefeated Jose Benavides Jr. Next on the scale, ladies and gentlemen, out of Santa Barbara, California, our hardcore boxing fans delight, Francisco Chia Santana on the scale. ...148 pounds, 148, the official weight for Jose Francisco Chia Santana. Santana Jose Benavides, part of our pay-per-view telecast tomorrow evening here at the MGM Grand Arena, 10 rounds, welterweight division. Ladies and gentlemen, also joining us on stage, unfortunately, he wasn't able to participate in our pay-per-view broadcast due to an injury. He is the reigning super middleweight champion of the world. A round of applause for Gilberto El Zurdo Ramirez on the stage. Look for him back this fall to defend his world title. Thank you. Again, ladies and gentlemen, tomorrow night the theme is the best fighting the best. Our main event, Crawford-Postol unification. Opening up the pay-per-view telecast, Benavidez Jr., Santana. 10 rounds, welterweights. Putting his undefeated record on the line, Jose Benavidez Jr., and coming for his O, you have Francisco Chia Santana. Tomorrow night on the biggest stage in the sport, the MGM Grand Garden Arena.
Next up on the scales, you're going to see a two-time Mexican Olympian and a guy fighting for his chance at a first world title in Oscar Valdez. He trains with Manny Robles at the Rock Gym in Carson, and these guys have worked so hard for this fight. He earned this opportunity by beating Gradovich in his last fight with a spectacular knockout, and every time he gets the opportunity, he just keeps getting better and better. He had his HBO debut against Tamayo in a tough fight, knocked out Chris Avalos. He's been improving each and every time. Manny says that he feels like this world title shot is coming at a perfect time. That 126 belt that he is fighting for was vacated by Vasily Lomachenko, who moved up to the 130-pound division, which made this fight against Rueda for the world title at 126. Oscar this week has been soaking it all in, knows that this is his time, this is his opportunity, his moment. He's always dreamed about being a world champion. And Manny tells me he's extremely confident. He had no problem making weight this week. He actually had a chance to eat a few days, so that's always a good sign. So he's ready to weigh in, and I'll send it now over to my partner, Lupe Contreras.
Ladies and gentlemen, our next bout to the stage is our co-feature tomorrow night here at the MGM Grand Garden Arena, presented in association with All Star Boxing. It is 12 rounds for the vacant WBO Featherweight World Championship, Argentina versus Mexico. First on the scale from Tandil, Argentina, 26-0. 23 of those victories coming by way of knockout. La Cobrita, Matias Rueda on the scale. pounds, 125. The official weight for the fighter from Argentina, La Cobrita, Matias Rueda. Across the ring, going for his first world title, the two-time Mexican Olympian. 20-0, 17 KOs, Puro Nogales, Sonora. Oscar Valdez Jr. on the scale. 126 pounds, 126. We have a fight, ladies and gentlemen, going for his first world title. 12 rounds for the vacant WBO Featherweight World Championship. Usually when you see these two nations are trying to put in goals into the net, tomorrow night it will be ganchos al hígado going at one another. Argentina, Mexico, Matias Rueda undefeated. Oscar Valdez Jr. undefeated. Someone's undefeated record will go tomorrow night. And the spoils as well, the WBO vacant world title in the featherweight division. Once again, being brought to you by Bob Arum's Top Rank Incorporated, along with La Cerveza Tecate con Carácter. The motion picture Hands of Stone, the true story of Roberto Duran, starring Edgar Ramirez, Robert De Niro, Usher Raymond in the role of Sugar Ray Leonard, in theaters Friday, August 26th. Being broadcast on HBO pay-per-view, and of course, our host, the fantastic MGM Grand Las Vegas.
Both of the fighters in our main event have been pretty tight-lipped all week. They've kind of left a little of the trash talking to their trainers. But in catching up earlier this week with Terrence Crawford, he's extremely focused, had a tremendous training camp, and knows that his opportunity to win another world title and reign supreme at 140 is something that he's been wanting to do his whole life. Check this out. Two undefeated fighters putting their O's on the line, 28-0, both champions. Don't you agree that these are the fights that the fans should support and people in boxing should pay to watch, because it's champion versus champion, you guys risking it all?
Of course. This is what boxing is all about. This is where your legacy begins, and this is where everybody take heed of who is the best out there.
What does that mean that your city has your back?
It means everything. It means that you got support from your city. You don't have support from your city, nobody else is going to support you. So by them giving me support, that takes me to the next level because I know I'm not by myself.
And you feel that, don't you? You feel that energy, not only when you're fighting in Omaha, but that crowd, that support is growing now wherever you go.
Right, of course. Every place that I fight at, they come and support. So I love them for that.
Victor Postol not only has the same record as Terence Crawford, he actually turned professional just 3 months before Terence Crawford. But, you know, he's a pretty big underdog here at the sports books here in Las Vegas. A lot of people think that's not fair, that it's much more of a 50-50 fight, especially now that he's got some knockout power. He scored 2 knockouts in his last 3 fights with some impressive uppercuts. He was talking to our friend Crystina Poncher earlier this week.
What would it mean to you for them to say the new WBO, WBC unified champion? What would that mean to you with everything that's on the line and all the pressure? Because there's a lot in a unification fight.
Что для тебя будет значить, если объявят, что новый чемпион мира ВБО, ВБЦ Виктор Постол? Что это значит для тебя?
Ну, это для меня будет уже вторая большая победа. Ну, плюс я прославлю свою Украину. Я буду очень доволен.
So that will be my second dream come true, and it will be my second big win. It will be, you know, I'll be very, very happy, and this will be a good thing that I will do for my country. I will make my country of Ukraine very proud of me and very known all over the world.
Ladies and gentlemen, we welcome to the stage our main event tomorrow evening. It is unification. Crawford Postol set for 12 rounds for the WBO, the WBC, as well as the Ring Magazine Junior Welterweight title. First on the scale, ladies and gentlemen, undefeated 28-0, 12 KOs. The reigning WBC world champion fighting out of Kiev, Ukraine. The Iceman, Victor Postol, on the scale. 139.5 pounds, 139.5, the official weight for the reigning WBC world champion, the Iceman, Víctor Postol. Next on the scale, one of the fastest rising stars in the sport, the WBO world champion from Omaha, Terrence Bud Crawford, weighing in. £140, 140. It's official, ladies and gentlemen. We have a fight, 12 rounds for the WBO, WBC, as well as the Ring Magazine Junior Welterweight World Title. The best fighting the best. It is unification. Both 28-0, both world champions, both the best in the sport, Postol, Crawford. If you don't have your tickets in hand quite yet, make sure you get them. Absolutely the best fight you can make on paper. The best fighters in the division going toe-to-toe tomorrow night on the biggest stage in boxing, the MGM Grand Garden Arena here in Las Vegas. Both fighters absolutely chiseled, ready for tomorrow night. Once again, the main event, unification, Crawford Postol. Proudly presented to you by Hall of Fame boxing promoter Bob Arum's Top Rank Incorporated, along with La Cerveza de Gate, Born Bold, Hands of Stone in theaters Friday, August 26th, live on HBO pay-per-view. And of course, our host, the MGM Grand of Las Vegas.
I think this is the first time all week I've seen you crack a smile. You ready? I think that that's because Omaha is definitely in the building here to support you. What does it mean to you to have your city and all these people have your back on your first pay-per-view?
Oh, it feels good. I'm ready to put on the show tomorrow night.
What do the fans have to look forward to? Two undefeated fighters. This is the type of fight that boxing fans should support. This is the kind of fight that they should go and buy the pay-per-view.
Well, it's going to be action all night. All night. You got two top fighters in their primes, undefeated, both champions, both willing to take risks. I'm ready to put on the show tomorrow. That's all I got to say.
All right. You want to do a quick message to everybody out here to support you?
Don't blink.
Don't blink, he says. All right, Kieran, over to you with the other champ, Víctor Postol. Kieran?
All right, I am here with Víctor Postol and his manager, Vadim Konolov. Víctor, whatever happens on Saturday, you're a winner this week. Your wife gave birth to twins just the other day. How much of a relief is it? How much pressure does it take off knowing you don't have to worry about that anymore?
Как бы не было, никакой бы не был результат в конце боя, ты уже победитель, твоя жена дала, родила двух мальчиков, и он тебя с этим поздравляет. Снимает ли это давление дополнительное перед боем, то, что уже родились твои дети?
Спасибо за поздравления. Я хочу поблагодарить свою супругу. Конечно, это снимает. У меня облегчение и мотивация. Я зарядился энергией, поэтому завтра вы увидите классный бой.
Thank you for the congratulations. It's obviously it takes some pressure off, and I want to thank my wife for doing it without me. And I want to thank you everybody for the support. And it gave me more and more energy. I'm very energized and ready to do everything I can on Saturday.
A lot of experts think this is a really close fight, but in the sports book, you're like a 6 or 7 to 1 underdog. Does that upset you?
Учитывая этот бой и уровень этого боя, ты являешься андердогом 6 или 7 к 1. Тебя это напрягает как-то, удивляет?
Да, немножко есть напряжение, но в субботу я докажу, что я не андердог, раз и навсегда.
A little bit, yes, but on Saturday I will prove that I'm not an underdog once and for all.
Thank you very much, Víctor Postol. Now back to Crystina, who's with the promoter, Bob Arum.
Bob, as Kieran mentioned, some of the sportsbook has but a 6-1, 7-1 favorite. But a lot of the writers do think this is a 50-50 fight. Both of these guys are talented. Both of these guys bring in belts and undefeated records. This is what it's all about.
Yeah, I mean, this is, for me, an even money fight. So if you're looking for value, you would bet Postol because he's an overlay. I mean, to get 6-1, that's sort of ridiculous. But it's going to be a great fight. Terence Crawford is a sensational fighter. And, you know, we have so many people here from Omaha and from Nebraska, right? They're going to be cheering him on. And, you know, after the fight, when you go back to Nebraska, make sure you help us carry Nebraska for Hillary Clinton. Thank you.
We also have some bright young stars on our undercard. We saw most of them weigh in earlier. Oscar Valdez, you have Chia Santana, Jose Benavidez Jr., Alexander Vozdik, who got the opportunity. So people should get there early because there's going to be entertaining fights all the way up to the main event.
Right. Every fight on the card is an entertaining fight. Every fight is a competitive fight. I mean, it's a really big summer treat, this card. You're not going to forget it. You're going to see the stars of the present and the stars of the future on this card.
Thank you, Bob. We have one more of those future stars to weigh in, Alexander Vozdik, so we'll let him get on the scale. We'll see you tomorrow, Bob.
Thank you, Christina.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, we welcome to the stage our final bout, opening up our broadcast tomorrow night on the HBO pay-per-view. 10 rounds for the NABF Light Heavyweight Championship, the challenger out of Ada, Pennsylvania. 26 victories, 5 defeats, 1 draw. 15 by way of KO, Tommy Carpensi, facing off against the undefeated pro, the former bronze medalist from the 2012 Olympics. 8 of his victories by way of KO from Kharkiv, the Ukraine. The Nail, Alexander Vozdik. First to weigh in, ladies and gentlemen, the challenger from Pennsylvania, Tommy Carpensi, on the scale. £174.5, the weight for Carpensi. The defending NABF champion, former bronze medalist in the 2012 Olympics, from Kharkiv, Ukraine, Alexander Vozdik on the scale. £175, making the first defense of his NABF light heavyweight title, Alexander Vozdik, opening up our HBO pay-per-view. Ladies and gentlemen, we also like to mention on the stage, he is one of the most exciting fighters in the game today. He is the reigning WBO world champion. Look for very interesting future plans in the lineup, in the card for this young man. From right here in Las Vegas, round of applause for Jesse Vargas on the stage. Ladies and gentlemen, that does conclude the official weigh-in. Don't forget, the few select tickets still remaining for tomorrow night. The best fighting, the best unification. Crawford, world champion, undefeated. Postol, world champion, undefeated. Going head-to-head tomorrow night, as well as a stacked undercard. Make sure you join us tomorrow evening. Once again, being brought to you by Bob Arum's Top Rank Incorporated. La Cerveza de Cate, Born Bold, Hands of Stone. The true story of Roberto Duran in theaters. August 26th, being broadcast worldwide on HBO pay-per-view, the undercard on TopRank.com, and our host, the MGM Grand of Las Vegas. Thank you for joining us. We'll see you tomorrow night for a great night of boxing.
All right, well, as we said both guys would make weight. They all did. These are professionals. And now it's all done. The talking is over. The weighing in is over. Now what we have to look forward to is the fights itself. And as we mentioned, we've got plenty to look forward to. 5 undercard fights on TopRank.com, starting at 3 Pacific,
correct,
I believe.
Yep.
Hosted by our friend here, Miss Crystina Poncher. And then at 6 Pacific, 9 Eastern, the pay-per-view itself.
right? You guys won't want to miss it, as Kieran said. Spectacular talent. Check with your local cable provider. You have until 6 p.m. Pacific to buy the pay-per-view. Spectacular talent on the card. Undercard streaming on Top Rank TV. Doors open at 3 for Kieran Mulvaney. I'm Crystina Poncher for Top Rank. We'll see you tomorrow. Bye-bye, everyone.